In this screencast, I'm going to cover a couple different ways in which Excel and VBA interface and interact with one another. A couple different ways to reference Excel cells in VBA. You can use range, basically refers to whatever value is in cell A5. The value property here is actually optional. It's if you leave it off and just do range A5, then that just means it's the value. So we could do range A1 to C3. That just corresponds to the 3x3 array A1 to C3. We can also reference entire columns and entire rows. So D colon D is the entire D column. Another way to refer to cells in Excel, you can use cells. Cells 4-5 would refer to the fourth row and the fifth column. Active cell.value is another way you can refer to cells, and that just refers to whatever value is in the cell that's currently the active cell. In combination with all of these methods above, you can use the offset method. For example, we can name a range temp in Excel, and I can refer to range temp and then offset it 1, 1, which means you offset it one row down and one column over. As far as importing data from Excel to VBA, there's a couple of different ways to do this. First, we can assign a value A. A is going to be a local variable in VBA. We're assigning the value in cells 2, 2, so that would be cell B2, to the local variable A. We can do something similar where we say the active cell value, whatever value is in the current active cell, is going to be placed into X. And finally, we can say something like the range, a single cell or a range of cells, and that's equal to some variable called, you know, for example, B. Let me show you how we might do this. So I've got some values here. I can press Alt F11 to open up the editor. I've got a couple different subs here. So a couple things I want to point out here. At the beginning of any module, you always want to start with option explicit. That's optional, but it's a good thing to do because that requires you to define all the variables that you use, and it makes troubleshooting and debugging a lot easier. So I'm dimming, so that's basically declaring. It's dimensionalized. I'm declaring A, B, and C. This first sub, it's called getValue, and it's taking the value in cell A5 and setting that equal to the local variable A. If I didn't have this next line, we wouldn't really be doing much because VBA wouldn't be using that value of A and nothing exciting would be happening. So I've added in this message box, value in A5 is, and it'll display the value in A. One of the best ways to run a macro and to really see what's going on is to run it stepwise, and you can step through a function using F8. And when I go through, I press F8 on this line. Now I can go down to something called a locals window down here. So it's a good idea to have that opened up and enabled. And I can click on the module, and you can see that we've assigned a value of 17 to that variable A. And then I can press F8 again. That message box is displayed, and we see that the value in A5 is 17. So that's exactly what we wanted to do. And then I'll press F8 just to finish that sub. So that's one way we can sort of get a value. Usually you won't have a message box displaying it, but that's how we can import something into VBA. Some other ways, using arrays, I've got this sub where I'm saying A is equal to range A1 to C3. I can step through this, and it's going to set that array equal to A. So little a here is actually going to be a 3x3 array. In this case, I'm going to step through it, initiate that line of code. I go down here. I can open up the locals window, and you can see that we have A1, A2, and A3, which correspond to the different rows of A. Another way we can do this is to set a selection, and that we can set a selection to the value B. And I step through this, F8. We can see that it picked up B. B is now going to be a 2x2 array, which is defined by my selection. The final example here for actually getting something from Excel, I have this sub called getArrayPutArray. C is equal to the range A1 to C3, so it's going to take in that 3x3 array, and then I say range D5 to F7 is the value equal to C. So I'm just going to take C from A1 to C3 and place it back into D5 to F7. So this is more or less just a copy and paste. Instead of stepwise going through this sub, you can run the sub here using play. And if I go back to Excel, you see that it took the cells in A1 to C3 and placed it D5 to F7. Now let's talk about how we can use VBA to modify the contents of cells. There's a couple of different ways we can do this. It's sort of the flip of what we just went over. In order to import something, you just flip the order. Instead of saying C is equal to cells 22.value, you say cells 22.value equals C. So somewhere earlier you would have to define what C is in VBA, and now you're saying cells 22, which is B2, is equal to that value. Similarly, we can say the active cell value is equal to Y, range B3 to D6 is equal to 23. That will place 23 in that whole range. Similarly, selection, that's the selection that's highlighted in Excel. We set all those cells to the value of 10. So I've got an example here. I have a put value. I say B equals 25, so I'm defining B locally in VBA, and now I'm saying range A6 value equals B. And when I run this, I can either run it using the play. The final one is more complicated. We have a C is defined as an input box. So I'm not defining C in VBA per se, but I'm opening up an input box and I'm asking the user to enter a number to be placed in cell A7. There's a statement built into VBA called the for each. The for each will actually iterate through a bunch of different values in an array. So for example, I have something set up here. For each C in worksheets.range A1 to C3, which means for every cell in range A1 to C3, we're going to take the value in that cell and we're going to add 5. So what we're doing is we're taking the old value, adding 5, and assigning that to the new value. Sort of a variation on this theme, I'll show now. I'm going to put 5 in a couple of these boxes. So instead of using a range, I had a range, I can actually refer to a selection, so that's just a highlighted region. And now this second sub here, it's got this if statement. So I'm going to iterate through all the cells in the selection. If that value of each cell is equal to 5, then the new value is going to be 99.99. So I'm going to go in here and insert a button, assign this button to that for each if sub. And when I click this, I have to select my selection. And when I click the button, we're going to see that we replaced any 5s in there, and only if it's a 5, with 99.99. So I hope this screencast has been helpful. We've kind of shown how you can go back and forth between Excel and VBA and some nice ways to take data from Excel, maybe do something with it, see if it's equal to 5, make a change, and then put that back into Excel.